Good evening, plebe. What the shit? No, stop doing that. Good evening, plebeians! We're doing it live. We're doing it chaotic. We're doing it awesome. This is your Friday night edition of RCM On Tap, your 60-ish minute roundtable discussion show where we go behind the scenes at RivalCast Media to meet the cast, the crew, the people that bring you the quality programming you look forward to every single weekend. Joining me this week, as always, as I bring up our video, Killer McCoy and Biomed Alchemist, hooray! Did I unmute you guys?
I love how it was like the quality programming, and then there's Bio and Killer.
Yeah, very much.
It's like, aww.
Wah, wah.
Oh my god, I hate you guys so much. Not you two you this time. Not you two.
But you hate
this time.
So, alright. So, as you guys know, I keep IRC chat up during the show because it's a lot more stable than the Twitch chat.
That's just asking
for whatever.
It.
I know, right? So, I'm working between two keyboards. I'm trying to get the show started. You know, I'm trying to, you know, keep engaged with the people in chat as well. And every so often, when you're trying to rush things, you know, you bump a button. I mean, one of our common phrases around here is, Bio, I pushed a button. Well, Bio, I bumped the caps lock key, and now everyone in chat is deciding.
Why are you yelling?
Yeah, exactly. So now everyone in chat is yelling. And it's my fault, because I started it.
Yeah.
Because reasons.
Yeah.
Because reasons!
It's your fault. You should feel bad.
I hate you guys all so much. Not so much to quit the show, though, so you've got that going for you, I guess.
Darn it, Bio-Off Man didn't work.
Aww.
I don't know what you two are so upset about. We needed a night off, but we didn't want to actually take a night off, so
That's true.
Using tonight as sort of our relaxing on tap. We don't have any set guests. We don't have any set plan. We're just going to roll with the next 60 minutes with, you know, recapping the awesomeness that we have had over the last 37 episodes. This is episode 38.
Wow.
Seriously, we started this back in February, and yeah, we have not missed a week the entire run that we've had so far. We've had some incredible guests over the last few weeks. Last week being Petricat, you know, one of our good rival
friends. Yeah, Petricat was great.
You know, we've got more really cool things coming up next week. We've got, you know, Carl will be, we actually pre-recorded the episode with Carl, which I thought was a fantastic episode. I can't wait for the plebeians to see this.
I always look forward to Carl episodes.
I know.
Carl's a good chap. He's fun to talk with.
I know. And then we've got Sam from Operation Supply Drop joining us on November 6th.
Yep.
And then we've got, like, some amazing stuff heading into November. I mean, we've got some big wins under our belts here, gentlemen. I'm excited about this. For someone who really didn't want to be the one moderating this podcast every week, I'm excited every Friday night now. So thank
you.
You
know, all these guests,
though,
they've been finding out that Killer's on, and that's the selling point for him. They're just
I know, right?
It's like, wait,
I'm telling
McCoy's
you, it's amazing.
The Killer McCoy?
It's amazing how many
followers not laughing.
He has on his Twitter. I mean, every time we mention your Twitter handle on the show, it's like the next day my phone is blowing up with like five new people are following me. It's absolutely hysterical.
I heard his next album was going to be fire.
What was it? The first week we had it on and everything. What was that one group of people?
He's still there.
Are they still there?
Two guys. Two
girls at a time or something like that.
Yeah.
Two chicks, one guy or something like that.
Yeah,
something like that.
Hang on.
That's still an amazing.
He's still there. He's still there.
He's fighting for the dream killer.
It's beautiful. He was like your first Facebook follower or Twitter follower too. I get confused sometimes because I use the interchangeably.
Yeah. Yeah. You should see a psychiatrist about that.
Oh, my God.
Oh. Just saying.
Twitter.
Mm-mm-mm.
Looking up Killer. MC Coy.
La, 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 la.
So while I'm doing that. Oh, God damn it. The caps lock's still on. Okay. That shouldn't matter.
Why are you yelling? Why do you keep yelling?
Why are we yelling?
Why am I yelling Killer's name on Twitter? I don't know.
Wow, I think your husband might have something to say about that.
That's disturbing. Just a little bit. Just a little
bit. I mean, I could see Baron calling out my name, but you, Baroness?
He calls out your name in his sleep, and that kind of freaks me out a little bit.
Killer.
Oh yeah.
Two chicks at the same time is the
perfect. Oh, okay, line. Yeah. Yeah. Stay classy, Twitter.
Mm. Always. Always.
Yeah, we'll be mixing it up a little bit, speaking of Twitter. Be mixing up a little bit later towards the end of the show with the who tweeted that.
Nice.
Same game, just you know, changing it just this one time, because it's kind of hard to scrape these up, but yeah.
What?
I'm looking at Olive. Olive's always on point in chat. Aaron has confirmed to call out Killer's name in bed.
It's true.
Yeah, Paleo, you're not the only one. We'll have to see how we end up doing teams and stuff, because it'll be us versus another group.
All right.
So, but those of us who don't participate, we'll make our own team and just play Rocket League.
For those of you who have no idea what Bio's talking about, because, you know, context is important when we're reading from chat, tomorrow night...
Not.
Yes, it is.
Apparently, that makes it funnier.
You guys are ridiculous.
Killer declared it, therefore.
So tomorrow night, we're very excited. Saturday nights here at RCM, we try to do different community nights. Sometimes we do movies, sometimes we do community gaming. And, you know, we try to bring in as many of our rival friends as possible whenever we can. So next week, we are meeting up with our friends at Far Falcon Gaming for a Rocket League tournament, which I'm very excited about because, I don't play a lot of video games, but I love driving the little cars around and, like, jumping over people and trying to, you know, hit things. So I'm actually thinking about getting the gaming controller for the PC tomorrow so that I can drive better because, like, my hands are very, I don't know what the hell it is. I just, I keep sliding off of the W key and hitting the E and then I get
actually,
confused.
Audi. Baroness, what you could do is you can steal Baron's PS4 controller. There is software out there. You can hook up his controller to your PC.
As long as you've got Bluetooth capability on your...
No, not even USB, even USB.
Really?
Yeah.
Dude, you guys have
Oh, that's right, they do hook up via... Yeah.
My computer, I'm pretty sure, can take down satellites from NASA.
Probably.
If I you know, looked at the instruction manual. I'm just saying, it's pretty badass. But now that I think about it, because Baron's going to be working tomorrow, I could just grab his USB controller.
You could.
So that might be helpful.
Yeah, that makes a lot better. The only thing is that the instructions are put on there as if it's Xbox, because they just presume you're always going to use an Xbox controller on it. So you have to know, you know, that square is really X, X is A, things like that. Once you get these four buttons here, kind of remapped in your head, like which one is which, then you're good. But yeah, at first it's like, wait, what?
I'm just going to be sitting there with the controller upside down like I usually do, and just going to roll with it.
It's going to be glorious. It's going
to
be
fun. Now I'm picturing this menu in my head going, all right, key binding, all right, B goes to X, and square goes to...
Yeah, pretty much. It'd be like, you know what? I just want this button to accelerate. I want the start button to accelerate. Because why not?
Why not, indeed?
Well, I know that I was bitching the other night because when, the way that they have the keys naturally set with the keys and the mouse, like, they flipped what I would have set for left click and right click. Because I kept, like, left clicking trying to jump, and it was like the other one, and that makes no sense to me. So yeah, there might be some button rearranging tomorrow morning, Bio.
So good. Well, let's do that because, like, before match time instead of like
during the match
10 minutes before,
like Varyar would do.
I completely forgot about
in fact let's do it tonight after on Just
make a good
case.
Point. You make a good point. Okay.
If I remember correctly, Baron's going to be playing, doing a Let's Play after this.
Mm-hmm.
So
I can't take his controller, is what he's saying.
Well, you could. What you would do is you distract him, grab it, lick it, and it's now your own.
That's not how it works in our house. I have to pee on it for it to be my own.
Well,
that might short-circuit something. I'm just saying.
No. PS4 controller is a pretty well-built control. I'm just saying. Yeah, I have one here. I don't use it on the PC. But... Actually, now that I think of it, I have a second controller on PS4 that's still boxed up.
Wow, really?
Yeah. Yeah, I got it because I was intending to use it for some games that ended up not launching. Division.
Wow.
That was one of, and then after that, I was like, you know what?
It's no bitterness fine. There.
I can keep it. There's no point sending it back. died all the points out. So now we know why it's Baron's controller.
And why it smells.
He beat you to it. I imagine Baron, like, he has a staging area, like, in the garage where he has to... Anything he brings in, pulls out of the car, he's got to, you know, hose it down first and bring it in, like, ah, you can't have it.
We haven't needed that so much since we had the house, but, you know.
Oh.
I guess another option you could have is just have the cats attack him. Be like, attack minions! Fur babies! And they'd be like, meow!
I don't know what the hell they're doing upstairs, because Baron's at work right now, and I keep hearing them, like, clomping around upstairs. They wait until, like, 10 minutes before airtime, and then just go completely ballistic.
Yep.
Well, yeah.
It's, yeah. Killer knows what that's like.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah. Speaking of, where is Bella?
I think she's either outside.
Killer.
I think she's outside.
What? Killer.
What?
He's got that look that's like, we, you know.
Killer, it's 9:42.
Like, I can't tell
Do you
them
know
what
where
happened.
Your fur baby is?
Not my fur baby.
Totally is.
No.
It totally is.
No.
Yes, it is.
Actually, Allie, she might be leaving very soon. Yeah.
What?
Yes.
Why the hell would you destroy my weekend like that, Killer?
Because I
wow! Just
look
drop
that
bomb
dude,
on air,
like,
why don't
yeah.
you?
Yeah!
You're calling her my dog.
Feed me your tears.
I guess you guys are going to have to pre-record an On Tap to do your Calvin and Bella episode.
Dee, if you're watching this, we need to make a musical montage with that sad, like, you know, in remembrance music. And we're going to send it to Killer on a regular basis until we make him cry. Because I definitely, like, I'm getting all choked up here. I don't want to lose Bella.
Yeah, well, yeah. Ghost is gonna get a, Ghost is getting a new job up in the closer to his fiance and everything, so he'll be taking her out with him.
That's yeah. what he thinks, at least.
Oh, he will.
And until he gets a message saying, "I will buy your dog for $1,000."
No.
And then he'll think about it, and he'll be like, well, I could use some cash down on that wedding that's coming up. And that's how Killer gets stuck with Bella.
No. No. No.
I'm thinking that we need to start, like, I don't know, a Patreon account for Bella. Like, bring Bella on as staff. Like, call her a creative artist, because, you know... And then,
so her poop is her art?
No, no, I was thinking more like we dip her tail
make
in paint.
Make, like, statues out of it and dry it in
no,
the sun.
No, 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 okay, okay, here's what we can do, Vio. This is brilliant, alright? So we dip her tail in paint, and then we just sit her so that she's looking at Killer. So then she'll get all excited and happy, and she'll start wagging her tail, and that's when you have the canvas behind
no.
her, so it, like, paints. And we can sell
no.
those as art to finance her freedom.
Okay, in her defense, in Baroness's defense on this argument, I've seen stuff that looked worse that was called art.
So have
probably
I.
Good point. Problem is, she's not an artist type. She's the, she's a killing dog. Did I ever
that's
tell you guys this?
That's
no, no, no.
Fine. Yeah, you,
tell
the story. Tell the story. Because
okay,
you've told us, but I don't
I
think
told, yeah.
said it on here.
So basically, one day I got home early from work, and it had been misty all morning, so I was going to let Bella in because she's been outside.
He said the word.
Can't say it two times now.
Oh, shit. It was misting. Not mist
not
with why.
What were the weather conditions outside?
Not the other.
It I'm was
sorry,
misting. Anywho. So I go to the back door. I got up, you know, a towel to wipe her feet off and everything. And I pull the curtain aside to look outside and see where she is. And she's out there just standing. Shivering. It's like, oh man, she must be really cold. It can't be that cold. It's only like in the 60s. And like, Art knows, wait a minute, she's focused, laser focused out in the corner of the yard. Like, oh, she sees something, she's going to go pounce on it. She's slowly creeping, one step at a time. Then all of a sudden, she spins right into the corner. Birds fly everywhere. She's stays in the bushes for a little bit. She comes out with a giant bird in her mouth, all proud and smug about it, and walks off to the corner of the yard. Huh, I guess she doesn't need to come in right now.
See, you've trained her well.
She was trying to gather that bird so she could trade it for you, your cheesecake. She'd come up and just be like,
no.
Hey, killer! That's a Doc, really nice cheesecake.
You do not like my face. You do not like my face.
Look at this delightful bird that I just killed for you. It makes a nice trade.
Yeah, we had this amazing concept where Killer had a piece of cheesecake that he was waiting like a day or so to actually eat it. And we were like, yeah, knowing your luck, you're going to come home. And it's going to be like, where's the cake at? Oh, Bella ate it. And you'd be like, she can't even process that. And she'd be like throwing it up in a corner somewhere.
Okay. It's like, it went to waste.
Curse you, dog.
All right, so Olive is saying in chat, Bella should be the diversity officer of RCM.
She probably could be.
I second this motion. I second this motion. All right, so what do we have on tap for tonight?
Oh,
chaos! Total chaos!
We're doing chaos?
Interesting.
We have games, we have excitement, we have kidnappings. Who's in chat? Like,
who is in chat?
Not chat team? Proper. TeamSpeak. Yes, who's in TeamSpeak? Fucking nobody is in TeamSpeak right now.
No. No.
All right, Weeble, well, you know
he's in his private room. Or
keep it. Well, you know, I think he kind of wants to be kidnapped. I think that's why he made his little, like, den of solitude right underneath the tap room so that, you know.
It's totally not why he makes that room.
No. No, he doesn't. Something's wrong. Anywho.
Speaking of Killer, you have to watch this week's South Park if you haven't yet.
I did.
You did?
Oh my god, that was amazing. Oh my god.
I'm just saying.
Oh no, it's reality.
Oh, congratulations, this man donated $1 to stop world hunger.
Onto the $1 club.
Walks by and like everybody else is on the 20, 50, and 100 or whatever.
Yeah.
It's because he gets shamed into it. I can't. Yeah.
Oh, that's what the episode, one of the main plots is about, is getting shamed into supporting causes.
I saw the preview that you were very excited about.
Oh, so. It gets even worse. It gets so exaggerated.
That's true.
Have you guys shopped at Whole Foods recently? Because it's not that far
really,
from the truth.
Well, they have like a stand-up of a kid where the change is. At this little,
a little sandwich?
Yeah, with a sandwich in her mouth. And to get to the change, you had to pull the sandwich out of her mouth. And the robotic arm's really difficult. So he was like, why don't you put your foot on her face? That'll give you some more leverage.
And the change jar looks like she's like, aww. Yeah. So
it's
sad. Like,
oh, it's so terrible. That's exactly what they do.
Hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
So good. So good.
I do like their cornbread, though. It's very good. They make it with, like, this little honey thing, and it's just very sippy.
We have a Whole Foods somewhere down the road, but we've only been to it, like, once or twice.
We've got one down the
like
street.
To find,
from our
if you want to find, like, something really niche that's foreign. Some foreign spice.
Yeah.
That's about it. Because, you know, Kroger's not going to have it. And I don't go to Walmart, so.
Yeah.
Walmart
unless you have, like,
a stuff anyway, so.
Unless you have an Asian market.
True. We used to have one. I don't know if we do still.
Oh, I know.
On an island, we had one we can go to all the time. Mm. Like, pick up, like, actual fresh ramen. That was pretty cool. Not so much now.
Yeah. Our town has one. I know for sure. It's the things what happens with a military base. You get a very diverse kind of a...
Right. It's very true.
So, yeah, it's kind of funny. This little pocket in southwest Oklahoma.
It's a melting pot!
It's so good. You get all the great
Oklahoma
great
looks like a pot, so that works.
Yeah.
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 Yes.
Yeah. Although with ours, probably... No, we'd be kind of like the leftovers of the stew and everything, so it's all got all the different...
Oh, you're the crap at the bottom.
Yeah, the crap at
the
bottom.
Crap. Everyone's just like, oh, we're going to put some comment on that and let it sit before we scrub it out. I know that feeling.
Wow, that's the most terrible description I've heard of someone's hometown ever.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah.
Ugh.
Yeah.
I wonder what the chat's saying since we mentioned whole.
I don't know. We'll find out.
Wait, something about a safe space. Wait, what?
In my safe space. Yeah, there was a musical number about safe spaces.
I lost
it was amazing.
Something here. Old cheesecake makes great building material.
Weeblay wants to be the diversity officer.
He's
the only non-American. That's not exactly true, because Lee Haxor is British.
All of things that we should
Does
talk
he really
about.
Count, though?
Chaos will ensue for an hour. No, Weeblay is saying that, okay, they were talking about Bella being the diversity
should form
officer.
A council.
Yeah, they should form a council because they are the non-American ones.
Olive.
Does that mean that they get to make all the decisions from now on?
Hey,
I look like a pot.
Weeblay is saying in chat, which makes it official. Oh yeah, I created my TeamSpeak channel here not because I wanted Dove, but because I wanted to get on tap. See?
Is that what he said?
It's right there. You can read it.
Well, I can read it. I was asking you because I trust you.
Are you sure you can read it, Bio? I mean, we were raised in the American education system.
Yeah, it's true. I read good.
Yeah, but you went to a private school, so that's how I know you can...
Well, for high school.
Ooh.
Yeah, ooh.
Sorry.
Hey, I was talking to my former roommate, because he was showing me his place in Alabama, and he was giving me, a Skype tour of their place, him and his wife, and we got on talking about school for some reason. He was just like, hey... You should totally. They're trying to get me to move into Alabama, and they're like, "You should be a substitute teacher. It's like easy to do here in Alabama."
anywhere. Down
wait,
south,
wait.
Yeah.
Was this your father's uncle's nephew, niece's cousin's former roommate?
No, not at all. but
it
was
went over
really,
your head, didn't you?
Yes, it was. Did. It flew straight over.
Baseballs.
It was funny because we were talking about.
I got
teachers, like our language teachers, and he had mentioned like their Spanish teacher pretty much didn't know Spanish and just like pulled it like 10 years later was still like holding the book at all times when we were doing stuff, and I had to point go back and think about it. It's like, you know what, we were kind of legit because we actually had a Mexican teacher that taught Spanish, just like a little bit legit. I didn't take class. I took Greek instead because it was more interesting.
Really?
Yeah.
Whenever you're going to speak Greek.
Well,
when
no,
he
mine...
goes to Greece, because he'll float there.
Mine was an older form of it, though, so it was more like archaeology.
I'm trying to help you out here, okay? I'm trying to assist you in this argument.
I got to read impressions
it.
Of stone tablets.
Oh,
well, not stone
God.
Tablets, but, you know.
Whatever.
I tried.
So yeah, it was interesting. I bet you butter your bread on both sides.
Wow.
Yes, that's exactly what I do. And then I stick an ear of corn in it, and then roll it, like on War Games.
What just happened?
Now here's the question: is when I butter the bread and I stick the corn in the bread, does that make it a corn dog?
No.
It doesn't.
No.
Oh,
the corn dog
wait,
is fried.
No, because I need the stick. That's why.
Oh no, because
that's why.
Corn itself,
I need the
corn has to be fried. Think about, well, the bread has to be fried.
I need the stick. I understand. Thanks for putting that out there, Killer.
You need the stick?
Yeah, I need exactly.
Killer.
Because the stick makes it a corn dog, right?
Quick off topic question. What are you drinking tonight?
That's what I always drink.
Okay,
which I should get a sponsorship. Drinking my Glenfiddich 12-year single malt scotch. So good. Yeah. So, answers your question, right?
It does. It does. It means that you're the only one who's had any alcohol, and that, you know, kind of scares me with the direction this conversation has been taking.
Why are you guys not drinking?
Well, because I never drink. I'm having, like,
well, you don't
grapefruit
matter.
Juice. I know I don't matter.
That's so mean!
Just saying. I'm just saying.
Baroness, why are you not drinking?
Because I had a headache earlier and I didn't want to mix alcohol and painkillers. It's typically not a good thing.
That is true. You might kill your husband.
No, he came in a few minutes ago. I heard him rustling a bag, so I'm kind of interested into what he brought home.
Now, get your wow well.
I'm kind of hoping it was Chinese food, but I know it's not.
Oh, that does sound good now.
Well, my plan today was I was going to drop the car off because I had to get a new wheel put on it, and they're going to do it tomorrow. So I was dropping the car off after work today, and then I was going to take a walk in the park and take a bunch of pictures, which I did. And then I was going to stop at the Chinese place to get takeout for dinner and mm-hmm. then come home and do on tap. Well, when I was at the park, I was tired and I had a little bit of a headache. So I was like, I'll go take a nap or something or go home first. And then I just slept for a while and didn't do anything interesting.
Wait. So the reason why you needed a new wheel on your car is you were in a chase scene again. You're in a chase scene again, aren't you?
I wish I were. No, I think I told you this story last. I didn't send you text messages swearing about the junk man on the highway who didn't secure all of his stuff and was dropping stuff all over the road.
I didn't get this one, so tell the story.
Yeah, so on where my house is in relation to where my work is a 40-mile difference on all highway. So I live on one side of Cleveland in the suburbs, and my work is on the complete opposite edge of the Cleveland suburbs on the eastern side. So it takes me a little while to get to work. And in the middle of it is this bridge called the Valley View Bridge, which is a mile long, and it's about a mile off the ground, and it's a scary, scary, scary place. Anyway, on my way to work last week, I was behind this guy who was... he had like a junk truck and didn't bother to secure any of the stuff in the bed of his truck. So anytime he hit a bump, he was like, you know, the stuff was like jiggling up in his thing and going all over the road. So he did get pulled over, but not before he had already like sprayed a bunch of like lumber with nails sticking out of it and various other things all over the freaking road. I was back a ways, so the first cars to hit, you know, got a lot worse damage than what I got. I just had to, like, slam the brakes real quick and try to narrowly avoid things, which, you know, there was no way of avoiding this crap. But ended up kicking something up into the wheel. It, like, screwed up the tire, so they patched the tire for me last week, but they needed to order a new wheel for it. And, of course, Space Donut, you know, being the high-maintenance vehicle that it is, can never have standard parts. I don't know why I should just, yeah.
Are you saying that your vehicle is the bio of vehicles?
Kind of.
Is that what I'm hearing?
You're high maintenance?
Kind of.
No, just non-standard parts.
Yeah.
I don't know. Yeah, it sounds kind of high maintenance to me.
And it's funny because there's no reason it should be like that, but yeah. I have a very close personal relationship with my mechanics just because their minds are blown. They're like, why is it... Anyway.
This shouldn't exist.
Anyway, they take very good care of it, though. And it runs beautifully. I love Space Donut. I mean, she Space Donut does things that she's definitely not rated for a four-cylinder sedan to ever do. I mean, she's driven through tornadoes. She's driven through remnants of hurricanes. She's been through ice storms. She's been through floods. Oh, my God. She took on raging floodwaters like she was in an amphibious vehicle. It was amazing. And she didn't even sputter. I thought for sure that she was going to stall out and I was going to have to, you know. No, she was just like, nope, I'm a boat now, bitch. Vroom! It was amazing. So, yeah, I love Space Donut. Love her. So, she's at overnight camp with the other cars at the garage, and she's going to get her new wheel tomorrow, which we had to, you know... Oh, my God. It's crazy. Crazy.
Indie Paleomaster like a boss.
Yeah. Like a boss.
I think it's only fitting that Space Donut, you know, runs like a boss because, you know, she's my car. It's just how we roll around here.
They see you rolling. They see they being jelly.
They should be. Is that a Rio? Yes, it is. How is it doing the things it's doing? Because it's mine. So, anyway. So what have you guys been up to this week?
Got another gun.
See, I was giving you that lead-in, killer. Tell us about your new gun. In fact, don't you have it, like, within arm's reach right now?
Yeah, I kind of do. It's so pretty. See how pretty it is.
It's very...
So good.
It's very shiny and gun-like.
Shiny and gun-like. No, actually, it was funny, because, was it Wednesday night, I was on Bio and Lyser were on TeamSpeak, and I just got done doing, like, a little mini, 20-minute run on the treadmill. I sat down, started doing some stuff, and, you know, I've been looking for this, you know, that particular rifle for forever, ever since it came out. I was like, let's see what the current prices are, and see if anyone has one locally. I do a search on this website, and I look, holy crap, there it is! And I look at the description. Oh my god, the price is perfect! Then I started debating, do I do it? Do I have the money? I got the money.
Was that when I hopped on and you were like, Baroness, I've done something really, really stupid. I don't have money anymore.
Oh, I have money, but not as much money.
Not as much money, indeed.
I was like, damn you, Olive. It is a real gun. For real men. Or, you know, men who think they need guns to make themselves men, maybe. I don't know. Some people would say that, I guess, but...
Who's hailing Ted Nugent in chat?
I have no idea.
He's just a troll. That's all.
Of course.
All good.
All right,
speaking of Ted Nugent, though.
I let him go for a bit, but he just... It's time for my rant about the kids. The kids aren't very creative about stuff, you know. They come in and do things, it's just like, you know what, it'd be cool if you really, like, weaved something just amazing.
But give a story.
There was this one who weaved this story in during a operations supply drop thing, and it was actually really funny, but we ended up blocking them because they just kept doing it, kept spamming the same thing, but it was just this amazing, like, what the crap, and it's about Kanye West.
It was amazing,
but yeah. If he had stopped, you know, repeating, we probably would have let him keep going.
Yeah.
So yeah, kids, I'm just saying, look, you're entering a world that doesn't give a crap about you, and you gotta get good, and you gotta start being creative about stuff and original. That's my kid rant.
Or else the mighty banhammer gets thrown.
Brown.
I mean, anyone who goes to the RivalCast Media website and looks at our staff bio pages will note that we have little icons to show the different things that we do around the website, and BIOS has a very special badge of the mighty banhammer. So
I do have a lot of fun deleting you fools.
Deleting. Ooh, guess who just popped on the
team? That don't know how to do things properly.
Oh, it's like the fifth time.
Who just popped on the team?
Guess who's popped? Oh, and he popped into Best Korea of all places.
I think we should kidnap him.
I don't know who it is, because you keep, like, staring at me like I'm crazy. I just don't know.
Tell you, unfortunately, it's not one person named John Cena. It's probably second
you guys
best,
are
you know.
Oh, my God. You guys were supposed to have that queued up so that when I asked who is our special guest, you were supposed to hit the thing and then it would say, and his name is John Cena, and play the music. We talked about this before the show.
No, we didn't.
Yes, we did.
Nope, I'm denying that one.
Oh, I'm denying that. Yeah. Yeah.
We both fail. All right, so for the fourth time, who is in TeamSpeak?
Varyar.
Oh, grab him.
Yoink.
Our second favorite Marine in the entire world. No, I'm just kidding.
Wow. Wait. First of all, fuck all of y'all. And second of all, the show is earlier in my headphones now. I can hear everything twice and it's confusing me.
Yeah, confused.
Hi. What's up?
We're having a chaotic episode of RCM on tap tonight.
Just doing stuff.
Yeah. We're just rolling with it. And part of our plan tonight was we were going to randomly kidnap people in TeamSpeak to ask them random questions and then pop them back out. So
literally no consent. Literally no consent.
Wow.
You are
good
the
thing
first
Misty's
person
not here.
To
Holy
come
shit.
On
yeah,
the-
this is being broadcast live. Maybe chill with that no consent stuff, Bio.
Just saying.
Like, just saying. I'll have to talk to RCM Legal, but I'm pretty sure you're putting us in a very litigious position.
Well, we've already talked about kidnapping people, so there's...
Well, there's that. Kidnapping, come on, victimless crime.
This is kidnapping?
Wow.
Victimless crime, man. So you get some new parents, whatever.
Wow.
At least you have parents.
Yeah.
Unlike Batman.
Unlike Batman.
Yeah. I was about to say.
Okay, Velvet in chat is asking if they can ask random questions. Yes, yes you can.
Yeah, go for it. Why not? Wait, before I say that, I want to make sure.
Just it's remember, about to get real.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I want to make sure TP Poker's not in here, because he has some really freaking weird questions. I'm just like, where did you come up with this crap?
Well, just because no, you're they clean. Post he's not there. Chat doesn't mean that...
I know he likes to save them for RivalCast now.
RivalCast.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
He spends most...
Imagine Varyar has like a mile-long stare now. He's like, yeah, he saves them for my show.
I've seen some shit, man.
Have you?
Questions.
Questions. Apparently, Viewplay wants to know how
questions
tall.
About what?
5'11".
6'1".
I am proudly average.
You are
that's
average.
It. I think
holy
I'm 5'11" too,
like
something like that.
Blowing up. Wait, what? What bio?
Hmm.
Huh?
I was just saying I'm probably around 5'11" as well.
And I am.
Fair enough.
I am the sad 5'1".
Wah, wah.
I am literally, wah, like, wah. When we take group photos, people thought it was just funny because I was, like, at the very bottom, like, you could just see my eyeballs. But no, it's really because I am that short. Everyone's at least a head taller than I am, so.
You are small.
I am.
Tiny, compact.
I'm fun-sized. Screw you all. Fun-sized.
Your husband's well, in the chat. That. I plead the fifth. Had to be done, Baron. Sorry.
Diet Olive is asking, is your toilet paper splinter free? We're in America, so hell yes.
Yeah, duh.
Our white tushes require the best toilet paper the world could produce. Screw everyone else. We deserve the best, right? Varyar?
America.
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 Freedom.
Freedom.
Come on, chat, we need more questions.
Now so, I have to watch the Ballad of Rambo again.
The pandering about my being tiny but fierce is, you know.
The pander is real.
You guys can continue that later, but question time, question time.
Would you say Murphy-esque, Baron?
Murphy-esque. Actually, Audi sync. Seeing them once or twice and, you know, interacting with each other. Yeah, I would say because she keeps hitting him.
That is true.
I mean, I've seen the bruises.
All right.
Creamy peanut butter, you barbarian. Baron wants to know creamy or chunky.
Creamy. Obviously.
Creamy.
Yep, creamy.
What? Bio?
Listen,
really?
If I'm going to pay for goddamn peanut butter, I want them to finish making it.
That's a very good point, yes.
Usually you pick the alternating viewpoint just to provide some color and variety
actually,
to our
actually,
targets.
I don't. I take issue with that. I just have different interests.
Do tell.
I don't know. It's kind of funny. I was so mad about the XD experience when it wasn't their fault or anything, but because of the echo we were kind of hearing off of it, like, I had answers for all those questions, but since it was echoing in my head, I was just like, must say as little as possible so I don't have to hear myself.
Ooh. Here's a good question. What kind of... How many times have you crashed a vehicle?
Define vehicle.
Zero.
Define crashing.
Yes, I need both words defined.
We'll define
it. Yeah, define it.
Vehicle is a vehicle you can take on the road. Highway.
So something that requires
legally?
License plates?
Legally.
Legally.
So
legally.
License plates and license,
lots
okay.
of things will go on a highway.
That's
well,
very
we'll go license plates and registration, okay.
Right. And the car didn't have to be completely crashed, but it was damaged to a certain extent.
To a certain extent?
Yeah,
wow.
You need to
how
be more
wonderfully
specific.
Vague.
Okay.
Goose egg.
Jesus. Okay.
Goose egg.
It probably required over $500 in repair.
Twice.
Okay, then.
One of them, they hit me. One of them, that goddamn deer.
Well,
you're
deer
still going
count,
on
though.
About that
I don't
deer.
I think the deer counts.
I mean, it was like $13,000 worth of damage. My car's only worth $14,000, so I feel to get me over the stupid $500 barrier, the arbitrary number the killer pulled out of his ass like a goddamn Christmas card.
Hallmark by Killer McCoy.
Right.
You said zero times.
Goose egg.
Motherfucker.
I've had two or three little, like, bumps. I hit a gas pump once.
Well, that happened. And Killer gives you the slow clap.
Although, well, I can't...
It wasn't the pump itself. It was, like, the safety thing on the side.
Yeah. It happens. I can't say much because I've been in about... Let's see. I think my first accident... I probably should have died. I was in a 1979 Chevy Malibu. Anyway, I was going to school. The windows were fogged. It was foggy outside. I should have waited to let the windows get cleared up, but I didn't. I was in a hurry. Anyway, I went across the street, and at the same time, a semi with an empty bed truck, trailer, was zooming on the other side. As I turned into the inside lane, his bumper on his trailer caught the edge of my front bumper, ripped it off. It was literally, the only part of it was like sticking up straight up. That was the only damage. The only damage.
I should have died.
I got lucky. A couple more inches to the right would have been bad. And that was number one. That was number one. Number two is I was at my military ball prom, whatever thing. I went to go get the car and it was raining and I couldn't see that well. And I couldn't see the dumpster that was right next to the car. So as I turned, I ran right into it.
I'm sensing a pattern with you not letting your windows defog before you start doing things, Killer.
Another time.
Oh my God.
I know it's bad. I was leaving Walmart parking lot. This was not my fault. I swear to God. I'm driving and some girl who's going to the gas station right there, apparently going to her job, runs right into me. Luckily for me, I stopped. It was like a 15-mile-an-hour crash, but still it was damage. So that was that one. I think the latest one I would have to say is I hit a curb going probably about 25 miles an hour on a sharp turn. Yeah, totally wrecked the front wheel on that one.
That'll happen.
Mm. Yeah, what happened? Baroness.
Let me see. There's only been one where I really did a lot of damage. And it was completely my fault. But I told that story on Ghost on the Podcast not long ago because I was pissed off and I was driving and I was distracted for just a minute and then just ended up flipping the whole thing. And again, one of those situations where an inch either direction and we wouldn't be having this conversation. That one was completely my fault. I did have, like, my very first time coming to Cleveland on my own, I didn't crash it, but the car gave out. So this was the trip from hell. I was coming out to see a friend, and I had, at the time, I was driving this, I want to say it was a 92, but it was, it wasn't the Sundance, what the hell was it? It was a Geo Prism. It was a 92 Geo Prism. And, I mean, like, really beater college car, right? So, Cleveland, from where I lived at the time, because I lived in Pennsylvania, was just shy of 200 miles. So, I'm like, what the heck, I'll go. And drove by myself, and about, not quite the halfway point, I went to pull off, because I was going to stop and get something to eat along the way. Ended up running over somebody had, one of those bungee cords on the road. It was on the road. Hit the bungee cord, and it went right into the tire. Not only did it go right into the tire, but the way that it caught, it ended up wrapping around the wheel well several times. So this happens as I'm on the getting off of the road on the off ramp. So I'm like, all right, I pull into the, there was a gas station and a Burger King, and then there was like this weird little, like, it was a really creepy place. So obviously I'm looking at this tire. I'm like, okay, obviously I've run some, it's like embedded in the tire. I didn't see the thing wrapped around the wheel, but I could see that the hook was actually in the tire, and I knew this was going to be bad. So I go into this little, like the little gas station place. And this, I mean, this isn't like a chain gas station. This isn't like you're rolling into BP. This is like a, we'll call it an independently owned establishment. Completely dark, ranked of stale cigarettes. And the lady, and I use that term loosely, who was running the place was, I don't think there's a nicer way of describing her than trailer trash. I really don't. So she's like in these dirty overalls, like, I mean, just like really creepy. And has this big like barrel that she's spitting into as I'm walking in the door. Now, mind you, you know, I'm, how old was I at that point? 19-year-old college kid, you know, khakis and little, you know, preppy little clothes and stuff. She's definitely the complete opposite and spitting into this barrel. I'm assuming she was the proprietor because she's looking me up and down like, getting the heebie-jeebies just thinking about it. So anyway, I explain the situation. I'm like, you know, is there a tow truck or something around here that I can get this tire fixed? And she's like, all right, well, I can't call anybody, but if you, you know, when you leave here, if you take a left down the road and go down about a mile, there's a garage down there that can help you out. And something didn't feel right about it. So I'm like, where I was, I knew there was a big truck stop at the next exit down. So I'm looking at it. I'm like, you know what? I'm just going to get back on, because it was right along I-80. I was like, I'm just going to get back on the highway. I have my cell phone with me. So if something happens, if I don't make it over there, then I can call. But something just didn't feel right. So I got back on the highway. I got about halfway down and, you know, the tire just like it went, it deflated completely. All right. So I called, you know, AAA and the tow truck guy came out and he was asking me, you know, what happened, and, you know, I explained what had happened and why I got back on the road, and he's like, wait a minute, tell me what the instructions were she gave you again. So I explained, you know, what she had said and, like, the whole situation, and he's like, huh, you're probably good that you got back on the road, because if you would have done as she said, there's nothing but back roads out there. There is no garage. There's not. I'm like, ooh, ooh, creepy, creepy, creepy. So, all right. So now the donut's on the car, right? He's like, we'll put the donut on the car. It'll get you to Cleveland, but then you'll need to get, you know, a new tire when you're out there, right? We're still 100 miles plus out from Cleveland right now.
Yeah,
a little over 100 miles out from Cleveland right now. So, okay, the donut's on the car. I'm in the slow lane. I'm taking it. I'm on the turnpike the whole way, right? I am less than a mile from the exit that I have to get off of on the turnpike. And all of a sudden, the car just stops. I'm doing 55-ish. I was going slow because of the donut.
Yeah.
Just dead stop in the middle. I mean, there wasn't even time to get off of the road. I was just in the lane, and it just stops. I'm like, what the living shit? What had happened was, in this little beater car that I was driving, my 92 Prism, I'm pretty sure it was, anyway, the transmission fell out of the car.
Oh, no.
On the highway. No. So I've already done battle with, like, the creepy redneck lady who was trying to get me back into banjo country. I've already destroyed my tire and wasn't sure how I was going to scrape the money together to get the car to my hometown. Now I'm less than a mile from the exit in Ohio all by myself, and I'm just losing it. So my phone battery is still have a little bit of a charge. Now, this is like back in the days when you had a brick phone that you had to recharge. Yeah, okay. Wasn't very energy efficient. And I didn't have a car charger, so I was trying to be really careful with it. Call 911. Explain, you know, I'm on I-80. I said I was on the turnpike in Ohio, right? All right, I'm going to patch you through because, you know, the 911 dispatchers are like, there's a specific one for, you know, the interstate, and we're going to put you through to that, and, you know, you can explain where you're at. Okay, cool. She puts me through. Now, mind you, I'm in Cleveland. I was a mile away from the I-71 exit on the turnpike in Cleveland. She puts me through to the 911 dispatcher in Breezewood, Pennsylvania, on the Ohio, Pennsylvania Turnpike. When I identified myself, now mind you, again, there's like a swath of Pennsylvania and Ohio that I refer to as, you know, my territory, where I know all the cops because my grandfather was, you know, a state trooper, you know, Baron's dad was a cop, you know, so I know everybody. So when I get put through to the 911 dispatcher in Breezewood and identify myself, she automatically knows who I am and starts freaking out because she's like, "Where are you?" And I said, "I'm in Ohio." And they're like, why are they patching you through to us?" So it took a little while. I did get assistance, but yeah, that was my very first attempt to get to Cleveland, was the trip from hell. And then I still kept coming back out here. So there must be something about this place.
Or someone.
No. The someone wasn't until much later. This was completely. I don't even think I had met Baron at that point.
Wow.
So yeah.
All right then.
Yes.
Yeah.
That got a little more rambly than I had anticipated.
It's okay. Yeah,
it happens.
We have no plan for tonight, whatever. What other questions do we have in chat?
There have been a bunch.
Okay.
What do we have? Olive wants to know the place you'd most like to visit before you die.
Oh, that's a good question.
That's a good question, yeah.
The moon.
I would agree with that. No, I would agree with that.
Why?
Why? So many reasons why.
We literally can't even right now, apparently.
I could say, you know, another, you know, maybe Mars or... No, I don't know. The moon is... I read so many science fiction books about the moon.
And yeah, and I'd like to visit the Citadel, but, I mean, come on.
Well, also,
let's talk about real places, killer.
That is a real place.
Wow.
Back me up here, conspiracy guy.
Oh, are you saying we never landed on the moon?
Well, no, I'm not getting into that. It's really easy to tell.
I had to look at that footage
from the moon, which was actually a studio in Hollywood.
Oh my god, no, stop right now.
This was my whole goal, thank you, Bio.
I had to go and see.
Damn it, I walked right into it.
That all says the moon is fictional. Yes, that is absolutely right. It's not really there.
It's actually
a hologram
that
was put in place by aliens about, you know, 2,000, 3,000 years ago.
I'm going to go with Savannah.
Savannah?
Savannah.
Georgia?
Yeah.
Why?
I've never been down there.
I mean, it's lovely, all right, but, Scarlet. You know. It's Akron on the water, except cleaner.
Oh, there you go, then.
I've been there. That's what it is. I mean, it's nicer, I guess, but... I vote Rome.
Rome? Why?
Because it was the precursor to America.
Okay.
Okay, yeah.
I can
go with that.
Yeah. What about you, Bo?
Sea Killer? See how nobody laughed at my choice?
Wow.
Kind of hurt.
That just happened.
You made me come in here.
That's true. That's we did kidnap you.
That's true. There was no consent. I mean,
no consent. Remember legal, Bio. Remember legal.
You know, the sad thing is, I'm pretty sure that Bio is our legal person right now.
That's unfortunate. That's very concerning.
Let me consult our RCM legal department, www.legalzoom.com.
There you go. Legalzoom.com. Places I would like to visit at some point. I mean, I have several in mind. I mean, a lot of them just coastal cities. I've heard a lot. I've seen the ocean before, but never for a long period of time. So it'd be kind of cool to visit someplace along the ocean.
1 minute, Bio. You want to go to Tokyo?
I don't know. Tokyo seems really cramped. I don't know if I dig Tokyo as much. Maybe
you don't have to stay there. You're visiting there, or
that's what I'm getting. Though it's pretty cramped. I would admit that, you know, some Japanese city. Yeah. Conspiracy confirmed. The Roman Empire was the precursor to the Ottoman Empire. So does that mean America is actually the Ottoman Empire? Conspiracy confirmed.
Oh crap! We're almost running out of time.
We are almost running out of time.
Okay, so what other... What the living...
I reject your history, Olive.
Like a good American, you reject history.
I reject his history because the Ottoman Empire was a result of the decadent fall of Rome when they had lost their way.
Yeah, that's true. That is true.
Right now we're in the Republic phase. We still have to go through the Empire phase before that happens.
That's why I was really hoping during one, I don't care which debate on which side, but I wanted somebody to dress up like Emperor Palpatine. and the solution to ISIS would have been, we must raise a clone army for the Republic.
I volunteer to do that.
That is amazing.
I already have the cloak.
Peace.
I would do this. I will do this for you, Bio.
You would, yeah.
I would.
You would.
Alright, okay, next question. Baron asks in chat, did you ever find Bugs Bunny attractive when he dressed up and played Girl Bunny?
No, dear God,
it's a
no.
Cartoon.
Hilarious. Attractive, no. And Baron, I think you're projecting. Just saying.
Varyar already responded to it in chat, but I don't want to embarrass him, so there's that.
You and your starship.
And then I shall found America too. Freedom strikes back.
Everybody has to have a dream, guys.
I know.
It's true.
I know.
And America too will be a beautiful one.
Oh, Varyar, have you seen my new rifle yet?
No.
Oh, well, in about 30 seconds, you'll see it on the stream.
Yay!
Yeah.
So wait, good. what was I going to be embarrassed by?
I kind of want to trigger a killer right now, but I'm not going to. I'm going to be good.
I am shame-free. You can't embarrass me, Olive. I'm not wearing pants.
I was about to say, we should have worn no pants tonight.
Not already there.
Of course.
Beat you to it.
Again, I automatically assume if it's an RCM show that nobody is wearing pants.
I walk in the door, I close the door, my pants come off. It's literally in that order at almost all times.
All times.
America to the Freedom Awakens.
I like that. That's good.
So, okay. So to do that, do you have to have, like, George Washington and Thomas Jefferson show up in the Millennium Falcon and be like, we're home, in the trailer?
Oh my god, that would be amazing.
Oh, I assume by the time I have a starship, cloning technology will have been perfected. Shots and yes, fired, I will hang killer. Out with them.
Shots fired. What a nice airsoft rifle you have, killer.
Ooh! Ooh!
It might even have metal parts.
It would have you ban him, but I know he's just trying to provoke me. And he can't provoke me.
You're being the bigger man.
I am a bigger man.
Like that.
That's all the ladies say.
Wow. And that just happened.
Look at that. Perfect timing, because it's now 10:29, which means we have just enough time to talk about. If you enjoyed our show tonight, which you damn well better have.
Oh, wait,
what?
We have to do the Twitter thing.
We have the Twitter thing.
Okay, well, you know what?
No one's following us. We can go a little over.
Yeah.
What's the Twitter thing?
Baron's following us, yeah. But...
Yeah, who cares about Baron?
It'd be like
he'll
5 be
okay.
minutes.
Yeah.
He'll be fine.
Although, our... What's the official name? I can't... Our Twitter thing?
Who tweeted that?
Something like that, yeah.
Hold on.
Speaking of our Twitter, our sponsor for tonight, though, is New from Electronic Arts, EA Hotels. Need a place to stay? EA Hotels, they promise the very best in comfort, and every year that they improve their rooms by replacing the wallpaper and tables with slightly prettier stuff, which won't make the room any more comfortable. Reserve your room today to lock in your chance to pay even more for basic items like sheets and towels. At EA Hotels, we overpromise everything since 2015.
What a great deal.
I know, right? I want to buy two rooms right now.
Yeah, the same thing with just, you know, some changed wallpaper.
Exactly.
I'm digging it. I'm digging it.
RivalCon 2017 could be in one of the EA hotels.
That EA hotel.
I'm sure they'll be upgraded by then, too. We will give you the very best of everything, RCM. The very best!
Yes, now that we have plugged our pseudo-sponsor, it's time for Who Tweeted That. And I got to change this from no guest to Varyar, because Varyar's here.
Yay!
Which I don't think Varyar's got to play this before.
He is now.
But we're going to do it a little bit differently tonight.
I don't know what's happening.
Special
okay,
rules
so
for
Who Tweeted It is a game where you guess.
I've seen you guys play Who Tweeted It.
Yeah.
Right. This time it's going to be a little bit different because I'm going to tell you who it is, and you're going to have to tell me if it's real or parody account. And the theme for tonight is people within the tech industry, tech and science. So that's what we're shooting for.
All right.
So you guys know the rules, 5 points to get it right, -3 you get it wrong, and once somebody's answered, it's dead, because this one is 50-50 in this case. So let's get started. Tweet number one. I'm irrationally happy that Shamrock Shakes will be available at any and all McDonald's this year. Smiley face. The tweeter is Marissa Mayer, CEO of Yahoo. Is it real or parody?
I vote real.
Varyar on the board. 5 points, baby.
People love Shamrock Shakes, man.
Oh, yeah. I forgot about those.
Okay, tweet number two. I drink water made from human feces. Here's an update on the machine that produced that water. It's tweeted by Bill Gates. Is it real or parody?
I vote real.
Right again?
God damn it!
That's right, ladies and gentlemen. You heard it here first. Bill Gates is an honest-to-God shit-sipper.
I think that should be a lesson for a Baroness and Killer that you miss 100% of the shots you never take.
Dude, I'm literally counting to two Mississippi and then just going.
You gotta jump in there. Gotta get in there. Okay, the next one. Hold up here again. I'm told that there is some fan fiction featuring me and Bill Gates. As long as the ball gag is DRM free, I'm fine with that. Richard Stallman tweeted it. Is it parody or real?
Who's Richard Stallman?
Yeah,
I'm gonna go parody.
Okay, Killer came through first on it, and Killer is correct.
Fuck it.
But who is it?
Richard Stallman was very much behind a lot of the open source stuff and GNU. Organization.
Oh, okay.
I think there's free software, that kind of thing. He's anti-DRM, that hence why they put that in the parody. But that is a parody account called Not RMS on Twitter.
Yeah. Nice.
Okay, the next one. Because you know I'm all about that data, no trouble. I'm all about that data, no trouble. Neil deGrasse Tyson, is it real or parody?
A tough one.
Tyson's a douche. I vote real.
And Varyar's correct again.
God damn it!
Varyar logic cannot be assaulted.
Like record, we're about to have the record score going. He's about to.
Yeah. I'm the best at this game.
The best around.
Okay, next. I heard your criticisms of us making Messenger a separate mobile app, and I finally responded by giving it a standalone website as well from Mark Zuckerberg. Real or parody? This sounds like something Porkchop would tweet.
Yeah.
But is it real or parody?
It's a parody.
Correct. We have everybody on the board. Sweet. And really, at this point, it could be anyone's game.
Wow, really?
Incorrect.
I mean, it's 5-5-15. If you guys actually start answering things, and I'm just saying.
I answered a question! Oh my god!
Yeah, but you gotta get, you know, two more. To tie with Varyar and then you have to get one to win.
I could
okay,
just mute Varyar,
next.
And we'll never know.
In 2029, a 350-meter asteroid will fly within geostationary orbit and be visible without a telescope. This is from Andrew Rader, an engineer from SpaceX. Is it real or parody?
I don't know.
Follows me on Twitter, by the way. The actual iterator.
Real.
Killer, you are correct.
All right!
He follows you on Twitter?
And yeah, Andrew Rader, yeah. And humorously enough, the asteroid is named Apophis. So, yeah.
Tell them they should name an asteroid after you.
SpaceX doesn't do that.
I feel like if it's close enough to get that close, we should blow it up.
No. We
are going to start just to be experiments safe. With
no,
that. That may be a good one to park in orbit.
No, why, what? Why are we not blowing it up, Killer?
No.
What's your
reason why we're not blowing it? Buyer, think about it. That could be our Troy.
No, you go get a Troy. You don't want Troy crashing into Texas.
No. It's going to be in it's going to come to us. We'll capture it.
Do you realize on the scale of space how fucking close that is?
I mean, it's fucking close.
Mathematically, all it has to do is go a little faster or a little slower, and somebody in the world is absolutely fucked when a giant rock the size of Rhode Island lands on their goddamn head. No, I say there's only one way to be safe. You nuke that bitch when it's still by Mars. We can send probes there. We can send warheads there.
Ooh, we can send Ben Affleck there.
Logic.
Oh, we can send Ben Affleck there, like in that movie.
So massive, he would knock it off course.
And, yes. Yeah, and then you could just make sure that the ship malfunctions.
Never returns.
Okay, next one. I like to route through ATL with enough layover time for the Kung Pao chicken from P.F. Chang's.
Parody.
Steve Wozniak. Yeah. Of formerly of Apple Computers.
He answered fast.
He already did, and he was wrong.
Oh!
Because I was... damn you, Killer.
That is real. Yeah.
I was going to say it was right. So Killer gets negative three.
Ruin the dream. Barrio's pretty much going to win.
There's
no way. There's no
way. Guys,
not anymore.
We're going to go ahead and do the last one.
Recent appearances on tap? Once. Recent wins on tap? Once.
There's a correlation there.
My victory is inevitable.
Okay, next one. For the win. For Varyar. Kickstarter is the modern day sharper image. Tweeted by Elon Musk, CEO and founder
Real.
Of SpaceX. It is parody.
Damn it! Ha! I still beat you, loser face!
I don't care.
That's from the account Bored Elon Musk. It's a pretty funny account. So yeah, that is how we play. So we have 12 Varyar, 7 Killer McCoy, and 5 Baroness.
Whoopee.
Hey guys. Hey guys.
What?
Yeah.
I won just by guessing real every time.
On the ones that happen to be real, yes. Well, no, you voted, yeah, you did.
No, I did.
I had to look through the grid again, yeah.
The grid.
The grid?
The grid.
Well, yeah, because I do.
Holy
this on
shit,
a
am I in Tron? You know?
Yeah, we're in Tron now.
Yeah, you're in Tron, yeah.
Where's my light cycle, you lying fuck?
Where the Back to the Future flying cars are. Same place.
Sorry.
I was going to join in.
We should have watched those movies so car. Bad.
Well, they're still free on Amazon Prime until the 31st. Free streaming, 1080p, baby.
Damn, we're gonna have to make it a night or something.
Yeah, I watched them. I ran them today while I was doing stuff.
Nice. Anywho.
Yep, all
right, are
that.
We ready to wrap up now?
I think we are.
I don't know. I don't want to get started and then get yelled at again.
Well, be sure to pimp the stuff. Pimp the stream afterwards.
Well, okay. Before I get into pimping the stuff. Which sounds just so wrong. Diet Olive wanted to make a rebuttal to our parody sponsor for this evening and say that he prefers Ubisoft hotels because if you get in there day one, there's a 30% chance that your room will have walls.
Nice.
We need to start giving points out in our... Because chat gets some
really interesting
ideas.
Then Olive would win all the points again.
That's kind of true.
Good point. Kind of stacked.
Yeah, kind of bit.
He is rewarded for both being clever and being loyal. That's how points work.
Yeah, which, speaking of points, we do have something coming up. Hopefully, we got to figure out logistics, but we're coming up with a way to reward you guys. And I don't think we've come up with the name, but I know in testing, I've called it Rival Bucks.
Rival Box.
Because we had that episode where we did talk about, well, it wasn't us, it was, Rival I think it's Ghost in the Podcast,
Rival
wasn't
Bucks
it?
Have come up a number of times, and it scares me how you guys kind of latched onto it and are making this a real thing. I mean, the fact that they had the entire argument about how the currency conversion would work between Rival Bucks and various foreign currencies was absolutely amazing. Astounding. When we finally get our own island and, you know, create the actual independent nation of Rival Castia and have our own economy and everything, we're already set. We already have the plan, and it's detailed and it's workable. It's amazing.
I even know where the island's going to be.
I know.
I mean, unless something better comes on the market, but I monitor that pretty much daily.
Yes.
It's not surprising. Not surprising at all.
All I can think of is Street Fighter with the fake bucks with Bison hat. Bison bucks.
Bison dollars!
That's all I can think of.
Good.
Like, it's going to be terrible.
It's all good.
So yeah, that's coming down the pipe. Hold on to your horses for a while, because we got to figure out some things.
There are some tech issues.
Yeah, there's some tech issues. And I need to register the bot name, actually, tonight. Because I was supposed to last night.
I still say that you should call the bot Henry.
Henry.
It's got to be the... I guarantee Henry is taken on Twitch. Let's find out.
You know
out if Henry...
Okay. We have Twitch.tv. To register RivalBot anyway. But look up Henry, because if Henry is not taken, I don't care if you actually
It's probably
use
a Justin.tv account, too.
You need to make Henry a thing for me.
Henry a thing.
Henry, yes. Henry exists. He has 13 followers.
Wah, wah.
Damn it!
Has 1,081 total views.
All right.
Wait, maybe we should go to Henry 2.0.
Are we still...
going?
Do you still want to name this thing Henry?
Yes.
She still wants to name it Henry, but, you know... You can call it, you can nickname it whatever, but, you know...
I'm only going to refer to it in our staff meeting notes as
sneaky,
Henry from here on out, I'm just saying.
That I'm gonna
sneaky
get confused.
Thief known as reality says otherwise.
That was an awesome episode.
That was an awesome episode.
Alright, so, yep. Plebeians, we are gonna wrap up because I know Baron wants to get started on... What the heck is he playing tonight? I don't remember.
I have no idea.
I thought for some reason he was doing Until Dawn again, but I could be wrong there.
Oh, yeah. He was
trying to kill everyone.
That's
no, he was going to open it up at the spot where you have to make the choice between the potential girlfriend chick and the best friend, and choose saving the best friend to see what happens because nobody does it.
Yeah.
That's what it was going to be. Okay, so stay tuned for that. But in the meantime, if you want to follow our exploits as to the road to Rival Castia, we'll call it, join us, rivalcastmedia.com. We have all sorts of different articles. We have different fanfics that kind of chronicle our amazing adventures. It may be a fanfic, but it's based in truth, people. It's based in truth. Latest episode of Agents of Arachnus dropped earlier today. Check out, follow our other shows on Rivalcast Media. D2D has a couple of shows going on Monday and Tuesday nights with Monday Night Bullshit and Storytime on Tuesdays. He's actually got a really cool special event for Sheep Moon fans coming up in just a couple of weeks. I'm not going to give too much away
What? No one watches Sheep Moon.
I watch Sheep Moon!
Blasphemy and lies.
Poor D.
For crying out loud, I show up in TeamSpeak as the Baroness, okay? What about this is difficult for you guys to follow along with? My God.
Cheap puns?
Oh my God. Anyway, you can follow D on Monday and Tuesday nights right here on Twitch, and he does his Let's Plays. Baron does Let's Plays on Thursday nights under Baron Bus, and he's just recently started doing them on Fridays after On Tap as well. Check out the Rivalcast on Wednesdays and Saturdays now for an hour at 11 p.m. Eastern right here on Twitch. Other Saturday events, in addition to our community nights that we've mentioned earlier, Chaos Will Ensue, our wonderful... I don't even want to call it quite a Sims adventure, because they do a little bit more than Sims. I know they're planning on doing a couple of other games next week for Halloween, a special thing. But Vampy and Dove host that show from 5 to 7 right here on Saturdays. I'm missing somebody. I know I am. I always do. And I apologize in advance, because, I mean, just Oh, Ghost of... Oh, oh my God, Ghost of...
Wow.
Your own show.
Wow.
That just happened.
Sundays. Sundays are Ghost of the Podcast days.
Mm-mm-mm.
I'm gonna catch holy hell for that one later.
Yeah, you will.
All right. So yeah, so you get to start and end your weekend with me. I mean, what more could be wanted in the world? So yeah, I mean, shut up, killer. We've got stuff going on every day of the week, plus written content on RivalCastMedia.com, so be sure to check that out. You can also follow us on Facebook and the Twitter, at RivalCastMedia, or at our respective individual Twitter accounts. Bio and I go back and forth all the time. Killer just mainly sighs at us and tells us how much he hates
us.
Although, if I recall right, he does have one that's going to be going out in a little while that has photos of his famed collection that he's very excited about. So, be sure to check those out as well. Guys, am I missing anything?
I don't think so.
I know we've got a bunch of stuff coming up for Halloween. Yes, I am forgetting something. Because we started talking about our community events. For those of you who want to join our next community game night, is tomorrow night. We're playing Rocket League with our friends from Far Falcon Gaming. Join us in TeamSpeak at 8 p.m. Eastern. And play some games with us. I'm very excited about this. I'm going to steal a controller. Yep. I'm actually going to be using a controller. This will be beautiful.
I don't know, Varyar, do you know how many people they're bringing with them?
1,000.
Nah, I think it's going to be like, I think they're bringing 4, so they'll have a full team.
That's what I was figuring. So we had some other people who were interested in playing too. So what we'll probably do is
break it up, have a couple games.
Yeah,
going.
Just break it up, have different teams, just have fun with it.
Excellent.
All right. Do you guys have any other shameless plugs that we need before we leave?
No.
All right. Stay tuned for Baron Busting Until Dawn coming up next, and from all of us here at RivalCast Media. Cheers. Oh, shit, wait, hold on, we're going back. No, because I mentioned it at the beginning, but I wanted to just, like, reiterate. Killer, you can edit this later, because
no,
I know that's
I'm
what
not
she
editing.
Wants to do.
No, I'm not editing.
Yes, you will, it's fine.
Wait.
It'll be beautiful. Hold on, we're still live. Anyway.
Oh. Wow. That just happened.
It did.
Next week on Tap will be on YouTube for our pre-recorded episode with Carl. So, I wanted to mention that. We still have a show. It's just, it's already done and ready for you guys, because it'll be glorious, because I'll be running around dressed as Little Bo Peep. So,
and I phone it in.
And I'm apparently a terrorist.
It happens. It happens. See, that's how you confuse the others, by dressing like them so that you can infiltrate them, and you're like a terrorist ninja spy.
Sometimes
you
life makes you a terrorist.
And you take
and you know
them
you
out
do?
With your new
you,
gun.
You just put that terror in there.
Okay. Now good night. Cheers, everybody.